Since the beginning of time, if you ever try to build a mid-range gaming PC that doesn't suck, every ama or akao and your cousin that think that they know their will tell you that you need to get a mid-range processor such as the i5 or Ryzen 5. But now, according to many of the whispers in the wind and my sources, the reliable ones, not the dodgy ones, apparently now there is another more affordable option. 来啦，来，来。 真的啦，来真了，来，AMD 这是来真的了啦，with the Ryzen 3 Thermaltake. Anyways, today we're gonna find out whether or not the new Ryzen 3 3100 and the Ryzen 3 3300X is actually good enough for gaming in 2020. How do they stack up against the even newer Ryzen 5 3600XT? How? I asked you lah. That's what I want to test. How I know? You tell me ah. You don't know ah? Then you might wait and watch lor. During MCO, as you know, AMD released two new Ryzen 3 processors, which is the Ryzen 3 3100 and the Ryzen 3 3300X. This one is very the cheap at 449 ringgit, and this one is slightly less cheap at 549 ringgit. This time I mean it, they are both hashtag cheap buy. So what is so special about these two processors eh? Wait, come I tell you, wait. Huh? Got the specs here. First of all, they are both quad-core processors with multi-threading that are designed to deliver good single-core performance mainly for gaming. So what's the difference between these two processors? Well, mainly it is the base and boost clock. The 3100 comes with a base clock of 3.6 GHz and a boost clock of 3.9 GHz, while the Ryzen 3 3300X has a base clock of 3.8 GHz and a boost clock of 4.3 GHz. Actually, they are so similar that it kinda hurts my mind. In order to bully them today, I have brought out the Ryzen 5 3600XT, which has 6 cores and 12 threads because it is extra threatening, so that we can find out whether or not the Ryzen 3 can actually game properly. This is the Taichi. These two are the silos, and we are gonna see how they stack up and is it worth upgrading to a Ryzen 5 if you only have a budget for Ryzen 3. And should you save the money to buy something else? All these things I will tell you today. So you sit still, sila duduk, jangan lari. Other than clock speeds, the main difference between the 3100 and the 3300X is the core layout. Since both processors are quad-core, they only have one CCD, which are chiplets linked together through the Infinity Fabric in higher core count CPUs. Just take a look at the CCX, which is the core complex that contains the actual cores. In the 3100, the four cores are spread across two CCXs, while the 3300X only has one CCX that contains all four cores. This design in the 3300X lead to a lower latency and makes it perform better than the 3100. Even if you overclock the 3100 to get similar clock speeds as the 3300X, there should still be a slight difference due to the CCX layout. Now let's put these babies into our test bench and then check it out. Here are the specs of our test bench. Starting with synthetic benchmarks, we first have Cinebench R20 just to set expectations in terms of best case scenario with each chip. No surprises here, the Ryzen 5 is way ahead in terms of multi-core scores because of the 6 cores and 12 threads. If you do any 3D work or multi-core intensive applications, you should just consider the Ryzen 5 here. In TimeSpy Extreme, the Ryzen 5 3600 XT scored around 9% better than the Ryzen 3 3300X and 18% better than the 3100. The Ryzen 3 chips lag even more in terms of CPU scores, but it's expected since this is just a synthetic benchmark. Moving on to games, we benchmarked the CPUs in mainstream games such as CSGO and Valorant, and some slightly more demanding games such as Shadow of Tomb Raider and Death Stranding. First, we have CSGO, and this is a mainstream title that is quite CPU dependent because it is older and it has an older engine. The Ryzen 5 3600XT and Ryzen 3 3300X actually traded blows, with both getting mid to high 300s in both 1080p and 1440p. But what is surprising is that the 3100 still gets an average of 244 frames per second on 1440p, which is good news if you have a high refresh rate display for playing CSGO. Next, we have Valorant, which is quite new and popular right now. Riot Games is actually famous for their optimizations for lower-end PCs, so the performance shouldn't be too shabby. The Ryzen 3 3100 managed to keep up at around 143 frames per second for both 1080p and 1440p, which is very much playable for a first-person shooter. As for the 3600 XT, it is getting around 50 to 60 frames per second more than the 3300X, which gets close to 200 frames per second. Ayo, how many more FPS do you want? 500 frames per second, you also will blame lag after dying one lah. No meh? For Shadow of the Tomb Raider, the Ryzen 3 3100 was able to keep up even at 1440p because you got a very playable 75 frames per second. And in 1080p, we got 91 frames per second. And the difference wasn't even that big once you upgrade to the Ryzen 5 3600 XT because it only got about 116 frames per second in 1080p and 78 frames per second in 1440p. Shadow of the Tomb Raider is actually quite GPU bound, so don't worry too much about the Ryzen 3 being a bottleneck. As for Death Stranding, it is the same story. The Ryzen 3 3100 is able to keep up at 68 frames per second at 1440p, while the 3300X gets a very impressive 90 frames per second and the 3600 XT gets 95 frames per second. If you're not after crazy high FPS numbers, it seems like the Ryzen 3 can already do the job. Finally, we threw in our usual real-world benchmarks, which is the Premiere Pro Render Test. Rendering one of our 4-minute videos in 4K CBR 50 Mbps, the Ryzen 5 3600 XT finished in 596 seconds, which is 35% better than the 3300X and 59% better than the 3100. By the way, we are using an AMD graphics card with hardware encoding enabled. If you have a CUDA accelerated GPU, you should be getting better results, though your mileage may vary. So what is the conclusion? Basically, if you're just using your PC for gaming, the Ryzen 3 processors here are perfectly fine, even with more demanding titles, because AMD have definitely risen to the challenge to give us very good price to performance ratio in quad-core processors that will not break your bank and save you some money so you can add that to your graphics card budget. Good, right? Buy lah, 449, 549. If you want to do more things like streaming, video editing, all that stuff, you should buy the Ryzen 5 because it has more cores and it can go even more. Wow, such a bad pitch. But you know what I mean lah, huh? But if you cannot afford, then I cannot help you lah. You just buy this too. Good enough for gaming. Simple, right? If you thought this video was awesome, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell, ding ding. And follow us on Facebook and like our page. And go and stalk all our people, even Azrai. Why? Because he is Lang Chai, and I will see you in the next one.